Hello everybody, my name is Bahut Deshpande, and in this video I want to kind of give you an introduction to the special kind of neural network called a convolutional neural network, and most commonly you'll see it abbreviated as CNN, or convolutional neural network, and we're going to see that it's going to address some of the issues that we were having with trying to use just plain vanilla neural networks for vision tasks, like image classification, for example. And so with convolutional neural networks, kind of the goal of this is we want to learn a hierarchy. We're going to learn a hierarchy of visual features. You know, and this is actually modeled after the part of our brain that deals with vision, the occipital lobe. And so, you know, the way that the occipital lobe works is we first look at these simple features, and then we move on to more, you know, complex features. And so what I mean by simple features is that we might have, like, let me do this in a different color, actually. So in simple features, we might have, like, lines, you know, or edges, you know, and whatnot. And it turns out when we combine these, we can combine lines and edges to make, you know, more complex features like shapes or even faces or, you know, and so on. And that's what the convolutional network is going to try to figure out. Is it's going to figure out this kind of hierarchy of these. We take these, you know, we're going to see at the earlier layers of the neural net, the convolutional neural network, we're going to have maybe very simple features, like edges, lines. There'll be a horizontal line, a horizontal edge, a diagonal edge or something. We'll have all these small edges kind of at the lower levels. And then you're going to see that we can add more complexity because then we can combine these lines and these edges in ways that we can make other shapes like circles and squares. And we can make those, you know, combinations of those and put them as things like faces or, you know, different kinds of objects. And so that's kind of what this convolutional neural network, the CNN, is what it's doing. And the fantastic thing about this is that we don't have to tell it explicitly what visual features to use because it learns these features. That's where the learning comes in with convolutional neural. That's what the weights and the biases are. They're these visual features that we'll be learning. And so this helps solve some of our problems. And one the operation that it does with this, as the name you probably guessed, is that it uses convolution. And so that's using convolution is good because that's what helps us, you know, with our two issues that we're having is we have fewer parameters when we use convolution and we can keep that spatial structure. And so let me first talk about this spatial structure. And it's because it's more apparent than the fewer parameters. So with spatial structure, we can maintain this using convolution. So maintain. We can maintain spatial structure using convolution. And that kind of makes sense because if I have an image and I'm performing convolution on it, you notice that the way that, if you remember how convolution works, I take that little window and I slide it over the image. Well, that's taking into account the position, the position of pixels and nearby pixels. And so that we kind of keep that spatial structure there. And then we have fewer parameters than if we had if we were like flattening out into a regular vanilla neural network. We have fewer parameters because we're having these shared weights. There's this notion of shared weights. And you're going to see that what we're learning are actually the convolution filters. That's what the network is trying to learn. Right? And so that's kind of the goal of the network is to learn all of these kernels. And before we were discussing convolution, you gave it a specific kernel. You told what the values of the kernel were, whether it was the identity kernel, a sharpened kernel, a blur kernel. Those were explicitly given. You had to give that when you were performing an image convolution. But with a convolutional network, the values of those kernels are actually what is being learned. Right? And so kind of what's happening with this is that you learn the kernel values, the kernel or the filter value. So that's actually what's being learned. And so I should talk a little bit about the way that this this the way that this works. And so how you build a convolutional network is that you build it in layers. So I mean that seems that might seem kind of obvious, but I'm not talking about like layers of neural networks. I'm talking about there's special kinds of layers that are used with convolutional neural networks. And so kind of the big one, the big the one that you probably guessed, the largest layer is called the convolutional layer, and that's usually abbreviated by conv, right? And that's we're going to be discussing that more in depth. Another layer is called pooling layers, and that's usually just abbreviated pool, and we'll be discussing exactly what that is. And then kind of the last layer is we have FC layers, that stands for fully connected, and that's just a plain old neural network, basically. And where it means you just have, you know, it's just a neural network. It's just like this is an example of a fully connected layer. And so we can kind of combine these layers intelligently. And kind of what happens with each layer is that for each layer, the input is going to be some 3D volume. I'm going to talk about this in just a second. Input is going to be a 3D volume, and then the output is also going to be a 3D volume. And so what happens from here to here is some kind of operation. That operation is dictated by what kind of layer this is. And so, first of all, you might be saying, well, wait a minute, why are we talking about volumes? You know, where does this come from? Where does this 3D volume come from? And so if you remember what an image is, it's just kind of like, you know, a matrix, basically, right? But we can actually describe them in a more general term called a tensor. And a tensor, and I'm going to, let me draw this out. So suppose I had like a red, green, blue image, right? So with, you know, given some spatial, suppose, you know, let me just draw it out real quick. So suppose I had like, you know, some image like this that's like 32 by 32 or something. Like that, just pretend that these two things match up. And so we have an image like this, but remember that we also have red, green, and blue, right? So how do we represent that in this image? Well, we just take the red channel and we stack with the blue channel, and we stack that with the green channel. And so what happens when you stack these, you end up with a like a depth as well. That was a really bad drawing. Here's a bit better. So you also end up with like this depth, this notion of depth. And so this is, you know, three deep, because we have three color channels, basically. And so we have, you know, three of these color channels where we have red, green, and blue. And so this this notion of depth is, you know, equivalent to the, you know, the number of channels or, as we'll see, it will be the number of filters, and we're going to talk a little bit about what that is. And, you know, and for, like, for number of channels, we're talking, by channels, I mean, like, things like RGB. Let me draw that a bit better. Yeah, I mean, things like RGB, for example. And so what's going to happen is we take this input image, and then we apply convolution to this, and then, you know, we'll get, well, we use, you know, any number of these convolutional filters, and what happens is that this ends up becoming, the output ends up becoming some different volume, like this, right? And so now this volume, maybe, let's say it's like 32, we use 32 filters, and it because we're using a different kind of, you know, convolution, we, you know, end up making this image getting a little smaller. So we kind of keep doing this, and the spatial complexity of this image kind of decreases until finally we get, at the end, we actually do have a fully connected layer where we flatten everything out, and we, you know, compute, you know, we will compute like the softmax. But anyway, this is just like a top level overview. I'm going to be discussing exactly where these numbers are coming from in the next video. But the point is with these layers is that you input a 3D volume like this, and you can make 3D volumes really easily just by stacking on these channels. And then your output is also going to be a 3D volume. And you just kind of keep doing these operations until you get, you know, at the end you have a fully connected layer where you do actually flatten everything out at the end. But that's okay because, you know, in the middle, before you got to that point, you were learning these visual features, and so it's fine to do it at the end. But this is where I'm going to stop right here, and in the next few videos we're going to be discussing particularly about this convolutional layer and the pooling layer, and at the end we're going to talk about how do you combine these, because you can't just, you know, haphazardly combine these. You have to do it in an intelligent way, and so I'll also just discussing some of the architectures, real architectures that are being used and that have been used in the past. But I'm just going to stop right here, and I am going to do a really quick recap here. So this different kind of model called a convolutional neural network is meant to help solve some of the issues that we were having with using plain old neural networks for vision and for images. And kind of the two issues that we were having was that we don't have any notion of spatial structure if we're using just a plain neural network, and we have a lot of parameters, because when we flatten an image out, then we have like tons and tons of parameters, right? That first layer, the input layer, becomes huge. And so we want to solve this, and so convolutional neural networks are kind of the approach that we can use to help solve this. And so how they work is they basically learn this hierarchy of visual features, like I say. So at the earlier layers, you're learning just simple visual features, like lines, edges, and stuff like that. But then as you go deeper in the CNN, then you're combining these lines and these features into more complicated things like shapes, or, you know, and you combine the shapes into other things, then you make like faces or animals, or, you know, and so on. So I can, as you go build up, that's kind of what happens. And so how they do this is using convolution. They have these convolutional filters or kernels, and, you know, using this approach of convolution helps solve the two problems that we're having. One is you do maintain spatial structure with convolution because we're dealing with image convolution, and two, we have this shared parameters because the kernel, we're going to be sharing all of the weights of that kernel when we convolve it without the entire input input image. And that's kind of what we're learning. What we want to do is, for regular neural network, we were learning the connections, these weights and these biases. But for convolutional networks, the weights and the biases are actually the values of these filters. So old convolution, you had to, with other convolution, you had to specify what the values of the filter or the kernel were. But at this point, the point of the CNN is to learn what those are. And how we build it is actually in these different kind of layers, right? You have convolution, pooling, and fully connected, which is just neural network. And each layer takes in an input 3D volume and outputs a 3D volume, with the exception of the fully connected layer. Technically, you accept a flattened volume. But all the convolutional, the layers specific to CNNs, take in 3D volumes and output 3D volumes. And I show how you can represent an image as a 3D volume. And we're going to be discussing a lot more about this in the next video. We're actually going to be looking at the most important layer of this. Because it's so important, I'm going to be spending a little more time on it. So the convolution layer is what we're going to be looking at. So that's what we're going to get to in the next video, the convolutional layer.